And that is a perfect example of both endings and beginnings. My divorce was the end of a 25-year marriage. Well, some of those years were happy ones. But it was also the beginning of an exciting new life for me, and it matched that in my late 40s, I was back in the dating world. So this is a short history of Nancy's divorcee love life. And first there was Jack, the labor lawyer. He turned out to be an alcoholic. Somehow it took a long time for me to figure that out, because he was a walking, talking, working full-time alcoholic. Then there was Philip. He was kind of a new age spiritual guy. He had his energy moved every week. He knew all about all his past lives. And he made business decisions based on his horoscope. Oh, plus he was on a macrobiotic diet. There was a creative guy named Giovanni. He was the crazy Italian architect. He was rehabbing old buildings and turning them into landmarks. In his spare time, he carved stone and wood into marvelous abstract sculptures, which actually very much resembled female genitalia. And then there was the senator. John was a banker and a one-term state senator. State senator. That lovely gentleman asked me to marry him and move to the suburbs. He wanted to send me a moving truck, pack up everything I owned, and move it to Payless Hills. I should have been suspicious when his idea of a night in the town was dinner at the Union League Club and after dinner drinks at a hotel piano bar. He liked going to the same places all the time because bartenders and waiters knew him and called him Senator. So in honor of endings and beginnings, I've written a poem about the Senator. Actually, I wrote this poem a long time ago. Years ago, that's why we call it Kill Your Darlings, remember? This is City Lady Blues. Don't carry me off to the suburbs. I don't want to sit on your front porch. My car stops dead in Harlem. Don't lure me out of being an O'Hare. Don't bribe me with your fancy house. I don't want to breathe that hungry air. You know I can't be your well-kept spouse. Can't you see I'm a city lady? Don't want to be a comfortable. Girl. So So, don't drag me to the suburbs, please. Don't buy me a big car or call the Lord. I don't want to get lost on the freeway of love. I'll take the CTA. I'll Can't you see I'm a city lady? Don't want to be a country girl. Actually, I'm afraid of giant parking lots. I like grit noise. I shop in the Reckless Records best. I don't want to be stuck in the suburbs forever. And I won't love you when the compass points west. Can't you see? I'm a city lady. Thank you.